who have that unequal access to energy sources in our country. And if you look into the stats, there's an indication that South Africa, despite it having very strong elements of a developed country, we have quite a number of our people still living in a third world country. And I think it is those type of things that needs to make it possible for us to realize that when we do something, we do it because we remind ourselves that there are others who don't have and we need to contribute to that. Ladies and gentlemen, I regret to say that since load shedding stopped, the trend for power saving has been reversed. And in particular, in some companies in the private sector, we have also realized, like I indicated, delegating the responsibility of this crucial issue to other executives. Experience of countries that have successfully emerged from these tragedies point out that this can only be defeated if the top leadership of government and the private sector work together. I trust that your presence here tonight will propel us to ensure that this issue of the security of supply is dealt with at the appropriate level. Today I'm talking to people who manage assets, people who understand that the importance of sweating an asset. We perhaps need to begin to report a return not on assets but on energy. In the same manner as we do with all other assets that we manage, with of course an understanding that some industries will show a better return than others because of their very nature. We should then perhaps use this data to determine which portfolio of operations we continue to pursue and which to halt. This is, after all, the way you, the captains of industry, decide the optimal portfolio that yields the best return for your investors. We are in the middle of a warfare, an economic warfare. It is important to understand that we may lose some battles, but we can not lose this one. We have been entrusted with the management of energy resources. In managing these assets for the country, difficult choices will have to be made. Like in any war, there will have to be casualties, but we need to minimize the bloodbath. The economy is facing serious decisions. It is clear that we cannot continue on the wasteful path that we have been on. It is even true that we perhaps cannot even continue on the same developmental path that we have been on. We have all seen the horrific unemployment figures which were released by Statistics South Africa only the other day. 1 in 4 economically active South Africans are unemployed. We are the ones that can change the situation. Ladies and gentlemen, as politicians, at times we hold meetings, gatherings, or different engagement platforms during the day, 10 o'clock in the morning. And sometimes when you get there, you find thousands of people. What goes through our minds is not being very excited to see the number of people that respond to your call. It worries us as politicians, as leaders, that if this time of the day, able-bodied men and women can come here to listen to you, it means there's something that is just not right. These people are not economically active or gainfully employed anyway. It means that the time that they have, they can only devote to come to listen to you. And you go back from that community being more worried than when you arrived, because it shows you that the number of people that can be able to respond to your call shows that they have got nowhere else to go. I'm saying this because in most instances, you don't find children there. Children are in schools because we've got a policy. Even a child of the poorest of the poor cannot be kept out of school because the parents are poor, or cannot be kept out of school because the parents are unemployed. The people you see there are people who will tell you when they have an opportunity to raise a statement or a question that I'm a matriculant. Others would be saying, I have got a diploma, I've got a degree, but I've been looking for a job since the time I completed my studies. And at times you ask yourself, are we training more and more of our young people into oblivion? Because you train them and they've got nothing to do after being trained. So it is important that we also do an investigation of whether we train people in the right skills that are needed in the country, or do we just train people because some of the companies have got access to bursaries that they train people, and then they train people that they are not going to employ. So they also create more of the challenges that we have. So we are also saying it is important that we look at what can be done to make it possible that we can really reduce of the number of people who are unemployed. We all know that an economy will not grow without energy. But that does not mean inefficient use of energy. We all know that the next few years are going to be challenging. As we build new capacity to supply the much needed electricity, we need to use what we got optimally. That also means making correct energy carrier choices. And we can't continue heating water with electricity. We can't continue cooking with electricity. We can't continue using electricity for heating space. We can't continue using electricity to generate steam when we used steam to generate electricity in the first place at 40% efficiency. We say energy efficiency is the first energy. Before we make more, we need to make sure that we use what we got more efficiently. We need to sweat our current energy assets, not only Eskom, but all of us. We need to understand how well we are doing against our colleagues in the same industry in this country or in other countries. We cannot lose this war. If we do, our country will not survive it. Without economic growth, we will lose the war on crime. Without economic growth, we'll lose the war on poverty. Without economic growth, we'll lose the war on AIDS. We cannot lose this war. It is only when we join hands to ensure sustainable supply through firstly efficient use of what we got and finally adding appropriate new supply that we can survive as a nation. Last year when I met with a delegation of the National Business Initiative led by the CEO that I indicated earlier on, I was particularly encouraged to hear about the commitment of the industry and progress that has been made with regard to energy efficiency and demand-side management. It is particularly crucial that this was based on the commitments made through the Energy Efficiency Accord, a voluntary initiative which has taken the country so far. And I need to congratulate all of you who participate on this Energy Efficiency Accord, because it is important that we understand that as the ruling party, when we say working together we can do more, it means putting all your efforts together can be able to realize the benefits that we have set ourselves. When I perused the report of the Energy Efficiency Accord, I've come to appreciate the depth of the commitment and the progress we've made in this program. This accord took place against the backdrop of the absence of even the most basic of the building blocks of enforcement legislation on energy efficiency. It was a period when it was clear to the government that unless a voluntary accord was signed, we are inescapably headed for trouble, as what we had hitherto taken for granted, that is access capacity of our electricity supply, was dangerously running out. Through our presence here tonight and working together with industry, we are once again given the opportunity to relive the spirit that drove the original decision to come up with the accord. The situation with regard to electricity supply is as precarious now as it was when the original accord was signed. In fact, ladies and gentlemen, our president, when speaking last week during the launch of the solar water heating program in Winterfeld, said, and I want to quote, "We have enjoyed over 13 years of democracy without any risk of electricity supply failure. It became natural for people to use electric heaters, stoves, kettles, and geysers, resulting in South Africa becoming one of the highest electricity users per capita in the world. We took energy for granted," close quote. Given the electricity supply disruption of 2007 and 2008, which caused in the main the inability of our utility company, Eskom, to meet the electricity demand countrywide, we are through our presence tonight